There he is.
That's a good.
Yeah, these are nice fish.
Meet Mark Hedrick. He's crazy about Lake Maumelle. Although some anglers like to badmouth Maumelle, calling it the Dead Sea, Hedrick has better things to say about the lake.
Ooh, look at this one. Boys and girls.
That's a keeper there.
That.
Let me see that thing.
Yeah, that's a crappie.
That's pretty.
That is a crappie there.
Lake Maumelle is situated just beyond Pinnacle Mountain and the western fringes of the state's capital city. It contributes about two-thirds of the water supply for nearly 400,000 people. And despite what frustrated anglers might say, it's also a very good fishing lake.
Look at that beautiful white crappie.
If you're looking for Hedrick, Lake Maumelle is a good place to find him. He spent countless days in search of most of the lake's popular game fish species. Hedrick's reputation for finding and catching fish on Maumelle is hard to beat.
You can see it dropping here.
Dropping pretty good.
That's pretty good wad of something right there. That's just a big wad of them right there in a brush pile, and you got some surrounding it. So I think we might give that a shot, see if we can catch something. And I think we can safely say they're on this side of the...
Between the buoy and the bank.
Yeah. Want to give it a whirl?
Sure.
See, there they are. They're right...
There they are, right there.
Yeah, that's a good wad of them there. See, they're coming out of that deep channel. They're getting up here on the edge, and they're getting ready to start moving the banks.
Are they hungry?
I don't know. We'll find out.
That's the important thing.
Yeah.
Hedrick uses a variety of soft plastic jigs, and he's not afraid to get creative if a certain color isn't exactly what the fish want. Color is important, but maybe not as important as the weight of the jig head.
If I'm fishing real shallow and they're up in the grass, I'm probably going to put a 16th ounce jig head on because I want it to hit the water. I don't want it to sink real fast. I want to swim it out, and I'm going to be in about 4 or 5 feet of water. If I'm in 14, 15 feet of water, I'm probably going to use an 8 just because it's comfortable and I can feel it. If I get out in the wind and I'm fishing that same depth, I probably want to go to a quarter. Anytime I got a lot of wind, I'm going to try to go to a 3/16th or something, quarter ounce, just because it gets down, and try to stay with a number 2 hook. Well, I catch some big ones out here in the dead of winter. They get down there and they just, those shad and everything get down here in those creek channels, and those big old crappie just sit there and eat them when they swim by. All right, we're going to make a couple of more casts here, and then we're going to go to a spot where there's some of that artificial structure right on a creek channel, and sometimes those crappie lay up in there right before they go to the banks. You know, the worst thing about that buoy sitting out there is when the water's 40-something degrees, you gotta get it out of the water. All right, let's make a move. See, they're still laying right there on the edge of that, aren't they? Look at that. But they are not biting today.
Central Arkansas Water worked with the Arkansas Game and Fish Commission and volunteers to place hundreds of artificial fish structures in Maumelle about 4 years ago, so you're never more than a short boat ride from a good fishing spot.
Crappie this time of year when you look at the bottom, it looks just like, when you see feeding crappie, it looks just like you're looking at a gigantic haystack on the bottom of the lake. There's some fish, look at that. See a haystack there? Look at that haystack. That looks just like a big old haystack, doesn't it? We got fish on the bottom at 40 feet and they're stacked up 24 feet below the surface. So you got 16 feet of fish there. That's a lot of fish. It's a big, you know, big school of them. So we'll see what we can catch there. Early spring, water temperatures mid to upper 40s right now. Got a wind out of the southwest. We're gonna fish in 40 feet of water. There's a bunch of crappie stacked up here. They're coming up about, you know, 14, 16 feet from the bottom. So there's a big wad of them here. We're gonna turn, face the wind. We're gonna throw out, we're gonna fish real slow and see if we can't catch a crappie. If we don't catch a crappie, I give up, we're going white bass fishing. Okay, I'm gonna catch me one here. I'm gonna catch one here, boys. I'm prepared to catch a fish. Let's go. Steve, when you're reeling, reel it a little bit. And since these fish they don't really wanna chase much, reel a little bit, then just open your bail and count to about 5.
Let it go back down a little bit?
Yeah, then just give it a little bitty lift. And a lot of times they'll come hit it after you do that. I do that a couple of times, just see what they're doing. Sometimes that really triggers them. Other times when they're biting, you don't have to do anything. There he is. Oh yeah.
Good one?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Need the dip net? Oh yeah.
There you go. Big old crappie. I think we want to take a couple home to eat, don't we? If you feel it even get mushy, set the hook. Oh, I had one right there and missed him. I'll tell you something about fishing this way. Fishing this deep, reeling back, it's not something that you're gonna learn on one or two trips.
You gotta feel it.
You gotta, and let me tell you something. If you're a bass fisherman, like that one just nailed it. You got one. Nope, you got the bottom.
Shoot.
Hey, you know what you did though? You scared it out of the brush for me.
Did I?
I appreciate that. Ooh, look at this one. Boys Ooh. And girls.
That's a keeper there.
That.
Let me see that thing.
Yeah, that's a crappie.
That's pretty.
That is a crappie there.
Look at that big old mouth on that thing. Good old slab crappie. Early spring, still pretty cold, but he's gonna be hot in that frying pan.
Light line is important in the deep, clear water.
Using 4-pound test. You know, you can use 6-pound, but when you think about it, think about percentage-wise how much bigger 6-pound is than 4. And these crappie are down there, they see good. It's clear water lake. This line, you get too big, you get 8 or 10-pound test in a clear water lake, it looks like cable to the fish. So use something like a low-vis green, a clear. I try to stay away from clear blue fluorescent. I don't like that color. I like just the clear or the low-vis green. And then just fish it slow. Because you don't want them to see that line. Crappie are about half spooky anyway. I'm gonna kill it here for a second, see if that works. Missed him. Usually don't come back and hit it. There he is though. He did come back and hit it. That's a good one here. I mean, that's a good one. Feels like it, yeah.
Another good.
That ain't bad. Look at that beautiful white crappie. How old do you figure that fish is, wild man? 3-4 years old?
I don't know, but he's not gonna get any older because he's getting ready to get eat.
There he is.
That's a good
one. Yeah, these are nice fish. Wow. Well, that is pretty.
Ooh, they're getting bigger.
Is that not pretty?
They're getting bigger.
Yeah, that's just another beautiful white crappie. I mean, this lake's full of black crappie, but these white crappie, they are just so, so pretty. I think I usually catch a lot more black crappie out here than white crappie, so I'll take whatever I can get, though. They all taste pretty darn good, wild man. There he is, right there.
Now, how
My
deep,
God.
How deep was it?
38 feet.
Right,
that's a big boy there. This may be the biggest one we got today. Oh, look at that one. That's pretty. That's a black crappie. See? That's not white there. It's a black crappie. Golly, those are pretty fish, aren't they? Oh, this is a good crappie. Boy, like I say, I tell you, if you don't get in the brush, you're not gonna catch it. Look at the size of that crappie. Whoa. That, my friends, is a big crappie. All right. I think we need to go somewhere else.
You gonna throw, yeah, save this for the tournament.
Yeah.
You gonna put him back?
No, I'm gonna let you eat him.
I'm not going.
I know somebody will.
Yeah, I do too.
How pretty is that? What do you think that weighs? What do you think that weighs? Pound and three quarters maybe? That's a big crappie.
He's pretty.
Well, all right, we're done here.
The next day's Lake Maumelle crappie tournament was bittersweet for Hedrick.
177 on that one. Let's check that one.
He finished third, but his son Matthew won it.
Not too bad.
Maybe Mark Hedrick should have saved that two-pounder for the tournament, but with the white bass warming up for their annual run, it wasn't too hard to lay off the crappie. Talking Outdoors is brought to you in part by Zimmerman Sports Center on South University in Little Rock.
Isn't that fun? They don't pull, do they, Wild Man?
Yeah, they pull good.
The white bass run on Lake Maumelle is a highly anticipated event for Central Arkansas anglers. Fish congregate on the western end of the lake to spawn, and as Maumelle angler Mark Hedrick shows us, even the early stages of the run can produce some memorable late winter fishing.
The water's up here is about 53 degrees. Those white bass are running up the creek to spawn, so we ought to catch a few here.
They did. The white bass loved this curly tail grub.
Look at that. That's black, I bet you. Yep. I bet that's a largemouth. Might be a good white, but I don't know it. That's a good white. That's not bad.
White bass usually run up the Maumelle River in March, but they'll stage around the Highway 10 bridge several weeks earlier.
All right.
Oh, there he was. Missed him. Dadgummit.
Going too fast. Throw right there by that grass there, Wild Man. See, yeah,
I'm hitting some grass over
good.
Here, I think.
There he is. No, I bet I got grass. Yeah, I got grass this time.
Where's he going? Wherever he wants to. Another white.
Well, that's a good fish. That's a pretty fish. Well, they're eating it up. These aren't giants, but they are fun to catch.
Hopefully, the best is yet to come.
15 minutes from Little Rock, an hour before dark, and we're catching the heck out of white bass.
Just one more of Lake Maumelle's fishing highlights.